What is up, YouTube? Welcome back and or welcome to the channel. I figure out where the... I've got a new tripod system I'm working on setting up. So welcome to the fucking channel. I hope you guys can hear me. All right, it's raining. Ouch yonda. It's raining, so that's why I haven't... I set up my camera and all this stuff. Oh, this tripod's a little... I set up my camera and everything back here. And with the rain, you guys probably couldn't hear me that well. But welcome back to the channel. So this video is going to be a little choppy and here and there. Basically, today, I finally got some time off work. It was a rain day and ended up home early with a couple projects. I've got projects stacked up here at the shop, just personal projects. For example, 95. This is my girlfriend's. 1995 Trans Am. It's an LT1 car with the 350. It's a pretty hot little car. We've had some transmission work done to it and everything else. We're looking at getting it back on the road, some wheels and tires put on it. And yeah, getting it back on the road. I got that. I've got the 2004 GMC. It's a GMC Sierra short bed. Yeah, it's 5.3 truck, SLE, it's all power interior. It's only got 140,000 miles on it. Yeah, it's a, we're doing a, we, I'm doing a 5.7, I believe is what it is, drop on this truck. I'm gonna put it on a set of 22 to 24s. Depending on what we can tuck in here. Currently, if you all can see in there, or I can see in there. Yeah, that's what we're working with. I've got all the suspension out from underneath of this. I was kind of gonna make all of these projects a separate video as far as that goes, but I don't have enough of the stuff, my parts, I don't have enough of my stuff here to make 100% content. I don't have enough time to do that, so you guys are for now. Are gonna get bits and pieces of what I get done to stuff over time, but so yeah, GMC, it's gonna drop. You guys can see axles out from underneath of it on this truck. We bought this truck wrecked from an auction. It the back frame section here was bent from like here to here. It got hit the rear and bent the frame because it had a trailer on it. So. customized, we got some, I think that's half inch, it was round pipe at one time. I had a machine shop here in town, and then beads, boy, yeah, cut this in half for my notch, but it worked good, so that's all that matters. This kind of was originally a budget build. I've got the drop springs, lower control arms, lower control arms, all new ball joints, everything, all brand new. This is gonna ride like a Cadillac, or better, because it's got brand new everything. I'm ready to rust proof the frame, clean it all up. We got new dust shields for the axle. The axle's gonna get completely cleaned up. Yeah, got a lot to do with this. And then my most favoriteest, well, I got actually two more projects I'm working on. We've got my mother's 67 Volkswagen. It is, I made an earlier video on my channel about this car. I've got it completely basically tore down bare bones, except for I think I might possibly take the body off of, if y'all can see, take the body off of this pan and do some work to that. So I've got some work coming on with that. I got some work going on with the Trans Am, that GMC, just not all of it at once. So it's hard to do. I haven't got a full build video for anything yet. I haven't got anything spectacular, which is what I'm hoping to do with this, with my 1965 GMC. Focus in here. 1965 GMC. $4,000. GMC 4000. It used to be a grain truck. I bought it off a guy a couple towns away from here. The first original build, which I have some pictures of it on my Instagram, I might try and link it in here. It was on a 2002 Dodge Laramie 3500 Cummins chassis with a 47RE in it. It was, let's see, had 24-inch Alcoas with 37-inch mud train tires. I don't remember what they were. They were milled down and had the 10 lug adapters. It was four-wheel drive. I'll post some pictures in this video of it. But this go-around, I was originally thinking, you know, low to the ground. Like, just let it lay on the ground. Right now, the frame is currently sitting on the ground. I don't know if you guys can see that support. Way up cha, right in that little area. Won't focus. Yeah, but it's laying frame. Like, legit. So, this fucking tripod, we're gonna fight. So, I was thinking, you know, tuck everything, lay it on the ground. I keep looking over here and looking at that. So, sorry if this fucks the whole video. I don't care. But I was worried about laying it on the ground. Airbagging and all this stuff. I was like, oh man, I don't know. Laying on the ground. And I was like, two-wheel drive truck. I just feel useless because I want this truck to be used. I'm not saying that some of these trucks that are built can't be used, but before, that's what I originally was doing when it was building it to use. So this currently, the frame and chassis it is on now, that old, everything from the old truck is scratched except for the cab and the body. It's on a 2005 Dodge 3500 cabin chassis truck, basically. I took the body off of it and put this body on top of it, basically, on the frame. It's two-wheel drive. It's 24-valve steel, common rail injection. I've got the Painless Performance wiring harnesses on it, and to run it in the standalone, it's got the NV5600 manual transmission. And I think I decided I want to go four-wheel drive. So, yeah. But I've already planned around it. So we're going to put an MP205 Ford T-case down in here. And a 06 Super Duty axle up front. And just make it four-wheel drive. And run probably 10 lug adapters again. I'm still gonna run four link. The front will be just a simple four link, not gonna run a cradle or anything. The rear I'll probably just do triangulated, and bags in the rear for sure. Haven't decided on the front. It's not gonna be like, I want it more functional, so I don't know, we'll see. That's on top of these other projects. It's hard telling, but I'll get to that anyway. So back to what we're actually doing tonight. My nose is just itching. I don't know why. I keep scratching my nose. Get some booger sugar up there. No. But this customer brought in this 2002 or 3. It's a 6.0 Power Stroke. So brought in this 03 F450 to have the bumper taken off. He wants to switch out for a chrome bumper. Well, he's willing to trade even this ranch hand Low Pro. It's pretty nice, actually. Yeah, it's pretty nice. Trade even for a chrome factory bumper that'll fit this Euro truck. Well, I just so happen to have one off of my 02. Sad looking ass truck. My 02 550 out there. Brought you all with the hood stacks. Happen to have a bumper off of it, so I think for the build look, I'm going on that F550. That unit will work just fine, and I will trade up even all day. So that is what I'm working on tonight. So, and kind of the current projects. The next a little bit of video we will do, or the next video will be based around this 2004 GMC. After it's all lowered and everything, basically all I have to do is clean it up and get a little rust protection on it, bolt everything up, and I'm looking for a set of wheels and tires for it. Like I said, I would like 20s would be the smallest I'd like to go. 5.7 drop. 20s is the smallest I'd like to go. 24s is the max. 22s is the sweet spot. Not want to spend a shit ton of money. I'm really looking for a decent set of wheels with good tires. So, anybody around southern Indiana has anything like that, hit me up. But yeah, that'll kind of be the next project, working on this truck and getting it on the road, which, like I said, I have all the parts to do it. So we just got to get her done. And then after that's done and out, I'd say I'm probably going to get my truck in here, which actually that another project I'm working on, that O2 F550, it's a 7.3 power stroke. This is actually the engine out of it. I was going to do a separate video on it. It had a hole in the timing case cover that couldn't be fixed, so I had to order a new timing case. So I was like, damn, well, I got to pull everything out to get to that anyways. Might as well strip it down and not rebuild it, but reseal it from the bottom up, all the way to through the injectors, through the cups and everything. So, yeah. That'll be in one of the future videos as soon as I get time. I work full-time construction, so I do try to get in here as much as possible, but and I do not get a lot of the stuff filmed, but in the office, we got all the parts. Here's the new timing cover, high-pressure oil lines we've got going in. I'm going to go ahead and put a new oil cooler while I'm at it. You know, all kinds of stuff. So, yeah, I'm basically going to get back to working on this F450, getting that bumper off there and putting the other one on and getting her out the door so I can get on to something else. So, here we go. Fun as that was, that's done. It looks pretty good. The factory look, that's what he wants. This is actually a pretty sweet truck. I don't know what, I asked if he would sell it, and he said no. I'll look at the year real quick. It's kind of odd. It's a, I can't see. Can't see. 04. All right, 04 Super Duty. It's the Lariat. Look at this freaking Kachana. Isn't that fucking sweet? Back when they made a truck. But it is the four-wheel drive too. It's 8 lug instead of 10, but he does have the aluminum, the Alcoa's on it, so that's pretty cool. But yeah, that's out, and ain't no good way to swing this without fucking hitting something. Get this off, and we're gonna decide what I'm gonna do with it as far as putting it on the F550. I'm thinking about maybe doing a little different color, adding a couple pod lights, winch plate, some odds and ends. So let me know in the comments what you think about that. Yeah, so that basically wraps it up for tonight. I'm gonna clean up and yeah, and get stuff put away. Got that truck out of here. He wants me to take the service bed off. My lift's busy, so I don't really have time to do that. But, yeah. That's done. So, next thing I'm jumping on, I'm going to get that bumper out of the way. The next video I put out will probably be more of the GMC, the 2004 GMC Sierra 1500. It's about complete. I'm looking for a set of wheels and tires, obviously, like I said before, for it. So, as soon as I can get those on it, I'm going to get this cleaned up and put together. That'll be the next video. And get it on the road. It's a pretty slick truck. So I'll just do a specific video for that truck in this next go around.
but I figured since I haven't posted any footage of anything or posted any videos or what's going on, mainly because I haven't had time, that's why I've been working on a project at home for my mom, which I've got a little bit of video of it, what's going on, so stuff going on around the farm, here at the shop, there and there, so until further notice, this is the kind of videos we expect, so I do appreciate anybody that's follows me or watched this video. Please do follow, like, subscribe. I have an Instagram. I'll try to link it in the account below or somewhere in the description. Yeah, that's pretty much all I got for this video. So until the next one, peace out.